In this tutorial, we are going to look into the characteristic profile of the Thrillseeker archetype. Who is the Thrillseeker? The Thrillseeker is the part of self that lives life on the edge. Fearlessness is its superpower, and this archetype lives by the motto, "Here I come, ready or not," because danger is the name of its game. So, the Thrillseeker is the characteristic trait that is in search of the exhilaration, excitement, the euphoria, the chase, the empowerment that comes from doing something bold, risky, daring, dangerous. We are seeking that pleasurable kick, that coming alive rush that we get as we dance on the edge of the unknown. And there are three different types of thrill seeking. There is variety thrill seeking, conflict, and transcendental thrill seeking. Let's start with variety thrill seeking. The thrill seeker is our strong urge to pursue novel experiences that will add some spice to life and refresh the senses. Of course, we all need variety to balance a life that is compounded with routine and patterns. And it tends to be when the daily, weekly, monthly routine of life has become too predictable, certain, uneventful, stagnant, boring, and joyless, that we are naturally inclined to break that routine and get some type of rewarding thrill. The thrill seeker is a characteristic trait that we need to embrace for taking us on wild and exotic adventures and engaging with high energy activities that unleashes and electrifies the soul. The thrill seeker has the kind of fearless and gutsy qualities that will venture into the great unknown and tackle those risky propositions that will provide uplifting reward. Of course, where there's an up, there's a down. The balanced and sustainable life is one with structure and flexibility, schedule and variety. If, however, the thrill seeker is a strong trait, there will be a propensity to always seek novelty and the inability to commit to anything or anyone for a sustainable duration. The thrill seeker will always feel suffocated by people and situations that restrict its desires to fly like the wind and be free. Whenever that sense of freedom is curtailed and the need to exhilarate has been oppressed, the thrill seeker is likely to make sudden, unpredictable, and radical changes that will instantly cause disruption, upset, and confusion to the status quo, which makes it difficult to near on impossible to cultivate reliable and trustworthy relationships, nor dedicate oneself to a single purpose or long-term career that involves being in the same place and doing the same thing for too long. Next, we have conflict thrill seeking. If not regularly stimulated by life-affirming activities, the thrill seeker part of you will satisfy its appetite for novelty and excitement with cheap thrills. Cheap thrills are the easy and accessible ways that we find variety and stimulation, and yet they tend to be by creating situations of uncertainty and conflict in our relationships. The thrill itself arises from the relational drama and the subsequent intense emotions, the unknowingness of the outcome and the challenging aftermaths that ensue. Challenging conflict is where the action of life is. To feel alive, one must have something or someone to contest, resist, and persist against. Conflict is what sparks great debate and fiery exchanges, and both exposes, explores, and exalts the truth of one's position, character, and viewpoints. And playful conflict is necessary in relationships to keep the excitement, tension, suspense, and mystery alive. Because when the thrill is gone, most relationships die of stagnation. Therefore, the thrill seeker is a great characteristic trait to evoke the kind of playful conflict that keeps the flame alive. Looking at this archetype's detrimental impacts, the thrill seeker can have this overzealous, aggressive and combative win at all costs attitude that thinks in terms of how to outmaneuver and outperform others, where competition has exceeded cooperation. That's when conflict becomes outright war, where the thrill seeker is getting a kick out of destabilizing and dominating his or her opponent. If, however, we are always competing and looking to come across as being braver and more superior, then we're forever kind of isolating and alienating ourselves from others, which can lead to a sense of loneliness or being misunderstood. Doing whatever necessary to prove itself braver, the thrill seeker will taunt and coerce others to engage with dangerous activities against their better judgment. The thrill seeker will also make false claims and accusations and offer misleading advice in which to handicap the others, which places great stress on the relationship. Which brings me to transcendental thrill seeking. Not motivated by just conflict and variety, the thrill seeker gets its kick from anything that will give a pleasurable feel-good buzz, which tends to come from any experience or substance that elicits an adrenaline-fueled and euphoric sensation. Now, it's a long time to live within a fixed psychology and physical state, so sometimes it can be rewarding, alleviating and expanding to find some type of escapism from being the habitual self. The thrill seeker helps us to do this by taking on high risk and fear conquering activities like mountaineering, cliff diving, river rapids and skydiving. When transcending fears, we do experience this out-of-body experience where we are no longer feeling constricted and limited within. However, the detrimental impact of transcendental thrill-seeking is this. The most convenient transcendental thrills are those which involve the abuse of chemical stimulants or risking money and assets. When you are informed and aware of the risks involved with taking chemical substances, then the experimentation and ceremonial use of soft, illicit drugs and alcohol can be a pleasant experience. The thrill seeker, however, is likely to chase after the buzz, then abuse or become dependent on chemical substances as a regular means to escape from reality. With risking money and assets, the thrill seeker is likely to become a speculator and gambler who is getting a kick from high stake risks. When the thrill of the risk is placed before the consequences of loss, one is likely to come unstuck, making a huge loss and suffering failure. To summarize, the thrill seeker trait is essential to cultivate a desire, a curiosity to seek out novel and exciting experiences. The thrill seeker will help us to face the unknown, discover new experiences and conquer new challenges, soaking up all the different things that life has to offer. Risk taking does have a rewarding value and serves as an important evolutionary purpose. By expanding outside of our comfort zone to go after what we desire, we are more likely to get what we desire. He or she who dares wins. Where, however, there is a total disregard for one's self-preservation, a lack of risk assessment, safety caution, and preparation, the thrill seeker is liable to make rash decisions that lead to painful mistakes. Prudence, therefore, is necessary. So think about where the thrill seeker shows up in your life. Where in your relationships are you seeking a thrill? Where are you not experiencing the thrill of seeking new experiences? Are you seeking a thrill from drink, drugs, or conflict in your life? Has your life become too certain? Is there not enough uncertainty? Or is the thrill seeker a very strong trait in you where you are continually chucking things up in the air and making a complete mess of things, which makes it difficult for you to sustain a life that is certain and consistent? Once you've had a contemplation over the thrill seeker archetype, then move on to the next profile, where together we will discuss the archetype of the trickster.